Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this spooky text effect. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on a PC or Command N on a Mac. Make the size 1920 by 1080 pixels and a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll fill it with black. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, click the small double box icon or press the letter D on your keyboard. To fill it with the foreground color, press Alt-Delete on a PC or Option-Delete on a Mac. To fit it onto your screen, press Control or Command 0. Next, we'll brush in a dark blue color across the center of your document. Click on the foreground color to open the color picker. Type in 0C1F53. Then press Enter or Return. Open your brush tool. Make the size 1000 pixels and the hardness 0%. The blend mode is normal and the opacity and flow are 100%. Go to the left center of your screen and brush across the color. We're ready to add the text. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Helvetica New. If you don't have this font, just pick one with a similar heavy weight. The size is 225 points, smooth, and center alignment. Click on the color box and pick white. Type out your text. To move it, open your Move tool and move it to the center. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Click OK to rasterize the text. Make the blur radius 10 pixels. Next, we'll distort the shape of the text. Go to Filter, Distort, and Wave. Make the number of generators 4, the wavelength 113 and 271, the amplitude 5 and 35, the scale 100%, sine, and repeat edge pixels. Next, we'll smudge the text with the smudge tool. For this example, I'll make the size 300 pixels. If your text is a different point size, experiment with the smudge amount to get the results you want. Make the hardness 0% and the strength 50%. Drag out the edges of your text to make it look more ethereal. Continue until you're happy with it. To reposition it, press V to open your Move tool and move it. Next, we'll create the foggy atmosphere. Press D to revert your foreground and background colors to black and white. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge. Click on the thumbnail of the text layer to make it active and reduce the fill opacity. I'm reducing it to 60%. Change the blend mode to subtract. Make a composite snapshot of your image by making your top layer active and pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on a PC or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. I'd like to make the entire image brighter, so I'll open my Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L. I'll drag the input white level to the left to brighten it. My white input level is 186. Next, we'll give the image forced perspective to enhance its otherworldly look. Go to Filter, Distort, and Spherize. Make the amount minus 50%. will intensify the light source with subtle beams of light. Go to Select and Color Range. Select Sample Colors and make sure Localized Color Clusters is unchecked and Selection is highlighted. Drag the fuzziness to 82, then click OK. We'll fill the selection with white, but first, click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Since white is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. Make the amount 100, the blur method Zoom, and the quality Best. Change the blend mode to overlay and reduce the opacity to 50%. I want to adjust the color of the radial light, so I'll double-click on its thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. I'll type in AEF5FF, then press Enter or Return. Change the blend mode to soft light. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.